Let's understand how can we enable the routing in ASP.NET Core web application. You already know that the request has to travel through the HTTP pipeline. It means we need to insert some kind of code in this HTTP pipeline, and if we are inserting any code in this HTTP pipeline, then we call that middleware. It means we can enable the routing in ASP.NET Core by using the middleware. We need to insert two middleware in the HTTP pipeline. First, we need to use useRouting. The useRouting method will only enable the routing in this application. This will not map any URL to any resource. This will just enable the routing. Then use endpoint. Let's open the application in Visual Studio and let's see how can we use both these middleware. Here we are using the same application that we have created in few previous videos. Let's open the startup class. We configure the HTTP pipeline in this configure method, and over here in the previous videos we have used some custom middlewares. So because we are learning about the concept of routing, so I am going to comment all these middlewares, and now let's see what we got in this configure method. At the bottom side of this method we have this middleware app.useRouting. If you are using this method, the routing is enabled. Now second method is useEndpoints. So we have to use this endpoints, and in this endpoint we can basically map a resource. And here is one more important point: action methods are not the only resource that we can have in this ASP.NET Core web API application. Other than these controllers or action methods, we can also have some resource. For example, we have some static file and I want to create a mapping of that static file to a URL. Then here inside this useEndpoints method I need to write that mapping. But if you are using the concept of controllers, then we need to tell our application that yes, you need to map the controller routing also. So for that we need to use this mapControllers method. Now suppose you are not using this mapControllers method. It means whatever routes you have defined on your action methods, those simply will not work because your application does not know that it has to map the route of the controller also. You can simply say that this mapControllers is basically a bridge in between the HTTP request and the controllers. In ASP.NET Core web application, there are two ways to define the routes. First is the conventional routing and second is the attribute routing. Attribute routing is the widely used and most popular approach among the developers. So we have to focus on attribute routing.